Yo, Opus, we're live.
Hey, Bedford Central, how y'all doing?
We are back from BC.
Yo, welcome, and yeah, we're back. It's been the 10 days we've been off in British Columbia at numerous awesome events, the Great Canadian Glass Gathering, and...
I feel like we went a lot of places. Like, I want to say we went everywhere, and then I looked at Vancouver as we were flying from... I looked over BC as we were flying from Vancouver to Vernon and realized I didn't see nearly
enough. Ain't been anywhere.
I ain't been anywhere.
Well, to put that into perspective, I lived on Vancouver Island for 35 years, and I haven't been everywhere on there. Oh. And that's only 500 miles long. So there's a lot of space that I haven't been on. And BC, it rocks. It's an awesome place.
Yeah, tonight we're going to talk about our awesome trip out west and give you guys a chance to win a lot of prizes. And we also have Opus Live t-shirts for sale up front if you want to buy one, which I think may soon become a collector's item. I'm just saying, they might soon become a collector's item.
Yeah, we're already talking about changes to the design, but we will leave that alone for now.
And that'll be a surprise for now.
Two surprises.
I know things.
Two surprises.
And you guys can probably, if you guys want to buy them online, check out the Opus Live page. We'll have info available there. If our Facebook page, you'll have info on how to get your very own collector's item Opus Live t-shirt.
Hey,
and, all right, so. Oh, so people are talking, people are getting the Wi-Fi code so they can play online, yeah. I'm hoping.
Yeah, they're trying to get hooked up over there. It's, the Wi-Fi code is Free Mark.
Yes,
M-A-R-C.
As in Free Marc Emery, which we will be talking about later.
And you'll be able to play our games
online. So you guys will
online,
understand where the Wi-Fi code comes from, if you don't already know. All right, so as always, we will have Skunk Magazine subscriptions to give away. We're going to show you some awesome video of our trip out west, including the Great Canadian Glass Gathering in Birkin, B.C., and our visit...
The awesome Opus Live shirts.
Yes, the Opus Live shirts. You can't see them here at the front as well. And our visit to the Herbal Health Center in Vernon, B.C., a great dispensary out there.
That was a cool place.
We're going to talk about how you can help Marc Emery get home now that he is a free man.
Yes, no, he's not free, but he's not actually being held in detention. He's not actually being penalized. He's just being held in detention, detention.
He's technically now an illegal alien in the United States, so now he's in detention.
So he's not a free man.
No. So that's what we're going to get to. That's why I said free man. You weren't watching me, but I did this with my fingers open.
Oh, you made the quotation.
Free man.
The air quotation.
I air quoted.
All right.
So we're also going to tell you how to win an awesome LeFumo pipe and donate to the MMPR at the same time.
That's right.
We're going to give you a chance to win an awesome dab unit that we'll be auctioning off to benefit the medical marijuana patients that are fighting the MMPR. Which our friend Gary Wanna. So the MMPR actually stands for the Medical Marijuana Production Regulations. Our friend Gary Wanna has come up with a much better acronym for that word, for that term, and that is... Medical marijuana, prosecute regardless.
That's right.
So we'll be talking about a little bit of that and why your patients need our help. And, we're going to give away weed tonight.
That's right.
That got their attention. See, they're all fucking yappy until I started talking about the weed. So, yes, we're going to play How Much Does That Bud Weigh in studio here at Vapor Central. And you guys can play online by joining us in chat at vaporcentral.com or on Pot TV. And that's sponsored by our awesome friends at budbuddy.biz. So if you guys actually have your smartphones and your tablets in here as well, remember the Wi-Fi passcode is FreeMark. And you guys could actually have two chances to win and tell your friends to get their asses online or get down here to win as well. All right, so we should probably talk about the lovely t-shirt that I'm wearing.
The Great Canadian Glass Gathering. Before we get there, I'm just going to pull this Fumo out.
Oh, yeah, so people can get a look at the Fumo pipe?
Yeah.
La Fumo?
I don't know if you guys have ever heard of the Fumo pipe, but...
So this will... you can actually use this as a pipe?
I'm telling them.
Okay.
Hang on.
Sorry.
Well, I got it.
You were taking it out of the box.
Well, I got the mic. I'm talking.
Okay.
Anyways, the Fumo pipe, we're happy to have it donated to us by the people at La Fumo, the distributors. I don't know if any... Is anybody here familiar with Le Fumo? You ever heard of it? Anyone? No? All right. Well, it's this really cool pipe here that comes... It's a metal piece on the end. And what this one actually is hooked up with is a flower ball. And it has a spring-loaded carburetor. We're going to show you a video of someone using this in action. You'll be able to see better. But the cool thing is, it comes with a dabber, is when you unscrew this piece, and I'll show you up this on the camera up close so you get a good look. This is probably the coolest domeless nail I have ever seen.
I heard you talking about this online.
Yeah, check this out.
I'm going to hold it. Show this on Bud Cam.
On the Bud Cam, all right.
All right, so it's a domeless nail, but what's also really cool, so depending on who wins this, there's an actual extra piece that goes to this, which they did not give us. We'll have to actually, you'll have to order it from the company. But depending on what kind of bong you have, what this does is it turns any bong you have into a dab unit. So there's a little glass piece that will attach and go into towards the bowl. And but they did not send us the glass piece because obviously we don't know what glass the owners. But if you don't have a bong,
I think that
they
was
will
extra.
Actually.
And they, you have no, to order it?
No,
or are they going to give it to us?
They will give it to us, but they didn't give it to us because they didn't know they what. Didn't, they had four different types
right.
that they would send. So they'll have to find out what kind of glass
size,
you own.
For the size for of the bong.
Exactly.
The right. They fit
so,
different sizes.
So when whoever wins, Le Fumo will send the glass piece. And unfortunately, we can't demo that here right now. But this dab unit will turn any bong you have into a dab unit. And if you don't have a bong, they will send you an extra long pipe to turn it into a longer dab unit. So thanks to Tim and Yvonne from Le Fumo Pipe Canada. They graciously donated this for the MMPR.
Yeah, and we're going to be selling tickets to this. We're not actually giving it away as per se, but you'll be able to buy tickets over the next 6 weeks. And we've got the roll here. We've only got 300 tickets, so pretty good chances of winning this thing, whoever people step up first to jump on that.
Yeah, I believe the retail value on this was about $395, and I will have to check that. So if I got that wrong, Tim and Yvonne, I'm sorry. I will correct that next week.
And I apologize.
But I know that I'm close.
I apologize, Tim and guys. And Yvonne, I will. I forgot the paper at home that you gave me, the envelope. It's the one thing I knew I forgot. I always forget some. So that's what it was, but we'll have the details out on this, and also this is going up on the Opus Live page on Facebook, so if you want more details of stuff we're giving away and how you can win shit and get the upper hand on what we're doing, go on to Facebook and like us at Opus Live.
And we'll talk, we have this actually on the script for a little bit later, we'll tell you a little bit more on how to get tickets.
We'll be dealing with this again during the show. We'll bring it up again for sure.
Exactly. So I wanted to actually get to the Great Canadian Glass Gathering because that was our first stop on the tour.
This one has the little short piece of glass. So this one's just basically hooked up as a straight pipe. But let's talk about the glass gathering. Go. I have some glass to show from the glass gathering.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
So I got my... there is one waiting for Opus, but he didn't have your size. But this is my fabulous T-shirt from this year's Great Canadian Glass Gathering, hosted by Redbeard, who hosts a show on Saturdays on Pot TV. He does an awesome job about putting this event together. Now, I was talking to Casey, the coffee guy, earlier, and what a lot of people thought, he actually thought that the glass gathering was like in a conference center, like a lot of our trade shows were.
Oh, no.
He didn't realize this is camping on a mountain.
You're in the mountains.
And watching like 40 torches blow glass day and night. There were like 30, 40 torches going all weekend. We'll talk about the highlights from there, definitely. But
live music, glass blowing, outdoor camping.
If Cris can pull it up, he's got it here. There's actually a glass blowing video here of a video glass blowing that was actually happening the weekend that we were there. This was taken by Jeremiah at Pot TV.
Yeah, let's watch this. Roll it up.
I think he already did, actually. I think he had it rolling behind us while we were chatting.
While we were yapping.
I think he did. I'm not sure. There we go.
Line it up.
That sound was all weekend long.
So while this was happening, I was actually sitting in a bench kind of right across from this girl watching the whole table. I'm back there somewhere.
One side welded.
The entire area is on a hill. Everything is on a hill at this place.
I don't know all their names, but that was G-Girl, the lady you just saw.
That's
yeah.
G-Girl?
Is yeah.
it? Okay.
That's G-Girl blowing there, yeah. Oh, no, that's not.
That's the guy next
that's
to her.
That's the guy next to her.
Oh, yeah, lots of famous glassblowers that we've known over the years.
And something that I saw there this year that I've never even seen before, except on video, was a glass a lathe.
Oh, look, there I am right there. I'm in the background
Tracy.
Right there. And he was actually making a piece for Dory Dempster at that point.
Somebody knows Dory?
Well, the one, no, it's actually, that was him in the that was him in the video. But that round piece, the pendant that the other guy was making there, that was a piece for Dory, I believe.
Oh,
he's from
yeah,
the
yeah.
Vancouver dispensary.
Yeah,
because I was actually...
Dory
like
who
I
bought
said,
my truck.
He said, I was sitting there watching all of that happen. So, as you can see by the video.
Dory bought the 0420 truck.
So, what I will tell you about Birkin, however, is... I was not expecting to go to Vancouver in July where they tell you where it's mild weather. I wasn't quite prepared for mountains. That I would be sitting there wearing three hoodies and a pair of tights and a pair of jeans and still be cold.
We all had to purchase extra clothing and if we didn't bring a coat.
Again, thank you to the Mailman Brothers for the hoodies. You want to keep warm, go to a Prairie Boy, apparently.
I'm going to retract that wasn't G-Girl.
Pardon?
No,
it wasn't
I don't think G-Girl. That was
not G-Girl. Oh,
I think that was a new glassblower. It looked like she was learning.
Yeah, it just looked kind of like the long hair and stuff threw me off. And I got a closer look and realized, yes, it was someone training, I guess.
And you have to realize that Aaron and I are new to the glass scene, so we're trying to learn. This was our first really big glass gathering.
This was only my second, but, I mean, I've been interested in the glass trade for some time, but it was... I mean, like I say, I had never seen a glass lathe anywhere outside of a shop before. So actually, to see a glass lathe working in a setting like that is a little bit surreal. That belongs in a shop. So that was pretty trippy to see that. And then, of course, they had the crucible, mm-hmm. where they're actually melting glass and dipping in to a furnace with liquid glass in it, like 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit.
Which we are, I promise, Serenite. We are going to try to find you guys video of.
It was absolutely insane. This guy had this glob of molten glass on a pole, and he's standing on an 8-foot ladder with this glass on the end of a stick, and then there's like three guys underneath with another rod and a blob of molten glass, and then they're bonding two colors. So the guy stabs the two together, and then they're all pulling to stretch this thing out, and there's like guys are holding this ladder, and you know it's like rocky ground and all that even, and this is all rah, 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 and these people are pulling it. I swear to God, 3/4 of the people there were on acid. And I know because I was one of them. It was absolutely insane. I just to watch the whole thing was really, really moving, to say the least. It was,
and this was in
the dark at night under some.
Like I said, we are going to try to find you guys video of that. The linking up of videos today. We got back from BC last night, and after the unpacking, there were some computer issues. So we got as many links and as many videos up for you guys today as we can.
Yeah, we've tried to upload as you know. Do what we can in a few hours we've had since we got back. This, you know, I'm getting used to this, and it's not that great, eh? You get off a plane and do a show? Not easy.
Yeah, well, I had to go get a dog.
We did that last week, too.
Well, I had to go
I did that when I got here in January.
And I had to go get a dog.
Yeah. And this is our 25th episode here in Vapor Central.
So
next week, six months. Great show last week, by the way.
Hey, yes. Thanks very much. Yeah,
oh, yeah,
that was absolutely
we're
a blast.
Talking about that coming
we're
up.
We're going to bring that up in
we're
a minute.
We got that coming up, definitely.
I want to, okay, go on. What
so
I
we
wanted
talk
to
about
show
the highlights.
Off some, I want to
yeah,
show off some glass.
Yeah, well, that's what I said. We want to talk about the highlights
all
from
right.
the glass gathering.
So I got a couple thin glasses, pieces of glass here. I'm going to throw them up on the bud cam. First of all, I've got this really cool marble with a face in it that was given to me by Deb, and I looked it up. I don't have her contact because I have photos to send her, so I tried to get her name, but she was one of the lady there at the glass gathering, and I'll throw this on the bud cam. You can check this out. It's got the coolest face in this marble.
Turn it a little bit. Oh, it's hard to pick up. This is a really great profile cameo in the marbles that she did. And unfortunately, they don't transfer very well in the cam. But, it's kind of hard to tell.
It's still zoomed into the audience.
But it's still pretty awesome. We're trying one more time, folks. Thanks for your patience. No, a little bit, not quite. Yeah, you can't quite see it.
It's like a skull face in the marble. And the other cool thing I got was Cris at Top Knot Glass, who made these really cool skull pipes.
So these are sugar skulls, actually?
Yes, they are.
Sugar skulls.
Sugar skull pipes, which is... Yeah, it's hard to catch
those
the detail.
Those teeth
in
are
these.
Like sharp and jagged. You can feel them. It's pretty
but
cool.
It's, yeah, and the it's hard to get the detail in the face. But it's a beautiful. They're beautiful pieces. I actually fell in love with them. There was actually they had one that was like a stand-up piece that actually had kind of like a gold skull, the same kind of style. It was just stunning.
But if you watched the show last week, somebody just came from the gathering and came up to CCHQ and gave this to me during the middle of the show. And Cris at Top Knot Glass,
You better pack one of those.
He donated it and gave it to me. And I really appreciate it. Yeah, I'm going to pack one.
Oh, I know why.
You better pack one of those because my alarm's about to go off. I just looked at the time, sir. All right, everybody, pack your bongs, pack your bowls. It's almost that time. All right.
That's right.
Are we ready? Not quite, but get them ready, folks.
Got a minute.
I like making sure that the whole lounge is ready for 420 in Vancouver because we want to pay homage to our gracious hosts that showed us such a great time while we were there. So we want to say thank
NBC.
You, Vancouver. And happy 420 Vancouver!
Yo.
Happy Vancouver,
I'm
BC,
just
and
go
everybody
to a quick
in Vernon.
Clip. Check this out.
I'm watching Opus live on Paw TV.
Nice. That's our friend Ryan from Mailman Farms in Manitoba.
Yo, the 720 bong along with BC. All right. So, here's the other pipe I got. And this was gifted to me, actually, by Yvonne from La Fumo Pipes. And thank you very much for that. This, it was funny, they were looking at some glass this guy had in a case, came along, and I jumped on this piece right away just because I noticed it was, this is an old style of white glass, and you're not going to be able to see it, but up close, you'll notice and you feel it, it's... You can't get a smooth finish on it. It's like pearls. It's rough on the outside. And no matter how many times you torch it or whatever, it's not going to finish any differently than that. It's an odd style of Chinese white glass that not many people use. I really like it, and I recognize it, like, on the spot. The other cool thing it's got, and I'll show it on the bud cam, it's got three little glass bubbles that are the color of amethyst, my birthstone.
Oh, nice. That's cool. All right, and then, you collect white glass. And
not only do I collect white glass, but I like to collect white glass in the shape of, like, human bones.
Yes, you told me that.
Like, if you have any body parts that look like white out of white glass.
So if you actually had, like, a full skeleton made out of...
Of glass? And each bone was like a pipe.
Oh,
yeah,
I think it should, like, the whole skeleton should be one pipe, and like a big giant bowl on the skull.
Yeah, where would just smoke out of?
Oh, somebody make me that pipe, please. Somebody make me that pipe. Just cause yeah, please. I'm sorry. Just everybody online, you guys all had images in your head of where you could smoke that from too, and that was an awesome image. You're welcome.
You're welcome. Just put that out there for you, Tracy. You know, I kickstart that imagery. All right. Oh, by the way, at Top Knot Glass, you can get a hold of Cris at happydedstuff@gmail.com. And that's dead as D-E-D.
D-E-D. So happydedstuff@gmail.com.
And he's got some beautiful, very detailed. He's on Vancouver Island.
Yeah, that. Oh.
And he makes some beautiful detail, well, judging by this piece. Also, yeah. By the way, he signed this with a titanium pen.
Nice.
Yeah, on the back it's number one, 2014 CB.
Oh, that's awesome.
So that's
pretty
cool,
they're beautiful
too.
Pieces. Like, I, Opus went over to ask on the pricing of them because I was kind of afraid to ask because they're that beautiful. So way to go, Cris.
Something else from the glass gathering I wanted to show before we get
yes.
going.
Yes, oh yeah, that's what we needed to do.
Numerous people were selling extracts in the name of Shatter at the glass gathering. And I just want to show you the kind of packaging that these people are using. These are like sealed foil packets. This one's very reminiscent of something you would get from the government. It's
yes.
got that same color, gold foil sealed yes. packet that Prairie Plant Systems kind of used. This one's... I'll just read you what it says on the front of this one. And they even have a photo.
They it's actually have a QR code.
Yeah, and a QR code as well. It's QI concentrates of WAPA shatter, quality of material nuggets. 89 hours in a vacuum oven, 10 FLIPS, run in a closed loop system with a distilled solvent and butane indica. Fruity taste at first with peppery aftertaste. Very relaxing, but not overpowering. Mild body, mostly cerebral. I mean,
now
pretty,
pretty
good packaging.
Now, I am going to give it to a few of the... I'm not convinced yet, guys, but I'm going to give it to a couple of the solvent companies out there that I met at the glass gathering. Some of them I had talked to while they were here at Champs. And I was given an info package to teach me about cannabinoid and terpene info and the proper purge rates of these that they're experimenting with and how their product is coming along. So I am going to do my research. Thank you, ma'am. And I'm not convinced yet. But all right, we'll look. I like the packaging, and packaging is half of it. So, you know, you're right.
Well, they're listing their processes and things on the packaging, and you know, you're hearing a lot more of this closed loop system and. So it shows promise for that industry, I think.
And what I like is that we actually had a conversation, and it was kind of, I had kind of made them think too, is that while you are promoting shatter and dabs and certain extracts, you need to realize that you need to promote the safety of them as well, because a lot of people are doing this. It's an unregulated industry, so if you've got teenagers doing it in their basement to make a quick buck, somebody might get sick,
yeah.
And that's... You know, that's just the way it is. Yeah. So you need to educate people if you're going to be serious about being safe and a medical extract
and making a quality product.
Yep, exactly. So so you'll have to try those and sample those and let us know what you think of the product.
All right. Why don't you tell us one of the things that you experienced was how clouds are made.
All right. So I've kind of been up in the mountains before, but I'd never actually really spent any time in the mountains before. And really awesome experience to be like sitting on the deck of your cabin, smoking a joint, having a coffee, watching baby clouds get made. So, all right. You know, and I understand the whole concept. You know, my mother, when I told my mother about it, my mother being, you know, my mother was like, What, didn't you ever learn that in science class? And of course I have. Like, I understand condensation rises and all that shit. But I had never actually fucking seen it happen.
While you're smoking a joint.
While I'm smoking a joint, drinking a coffee, watching baby clouds get made.
At the lakeside, at a cabin, at the foot of a gorgeous mountain.
Yep. So basically, well, you know, the condensation, wherever there's water or hot springs somewhere on the mountain, you know, the condensation will rise. And basically, I watched it rise and join with other condensation and form a cloud and then drift away. And that's, you know, that's how I spent my mornings while I were up at the glass gathering, which was just fucking epic. And so that is one of my happiest memories, is I got to, you know, I got to watch clouds get, you know, born. And my second thing, oh, this is kind of the biggest one here. So anybody that regularly watches the show or in the studio that is regular here, I need to tell you about the glass gathering miracle. I came home with 10 toes.
It's true.
I heard there was the back. What?
You know, for those who don't know, like earlier this year, Tracy lost a toe.
I did.
And, I've been on the quest. Like I've traveled. I've been to Costa Rica and Jamaica, Vancouver. I had a lot of searching, but you know, the clues were there. I found them.
Yep.
And true enough, we finally came up with the end of it. We found the crystal toe.
And I'm wearing it right now.
Why don't you show
us
the crystal toe?
It's a collaborative effort. So we need to thank a couple people along the way. Of course, Opus, who was, you know, successful in his quest, as my phone rings, because I had the alarm on. But sorry about that, guys. There we go. I now have 10 toes, made by Redbeard, and the made out of pink glass because I lost a pinky.
Yep. It was a pinky toe.
So I would like to thank everybody. Kind of one of the things is this has been a sucky experience, and it's either you own it or you don't. So I have chosen to own it and make fucking jokes about it and shit. And I would really like to thank my friends for joining in on
that.
Got
a butt camel on that?
Because that's really cool. That Cris is saying, one second. But I would really like to thank my friends. So, again, this was commissioned by Opus. It was made by Redbeard. And the hemp string that it's hanging on was made by the incredible Gail Quinn. So, look, I have a pinky. I have 10 toes. It's a little long. I don't know how big Redbeard thinks my feet are. But, you know, hey. I came home with 10 toes.
That looks more like a finger.
I know. But we're just going to say it's, you know, it's just a longer, you know, it's a long toe, but it's a toe.
No,
I'll take it.
That's not a toe.
All right, you talk to Redbeard then. You know, he might have been a little high. He might have been a little tired. But I love it all the same. So I want to thank you and thank Redbeard and thank Gail. Now, Gail Quinn... she braided me the chain for this out of hemp string. And that's actually who I want to talk about next. Gail is the partner of Ted Smith, the author of Hempology 101, and great activist from Vancouver Island.
Recipient of the Michelle Rainey Activist of the Year Award a year or so ago.
Of course. Gail has been... fighting a really, really fucking hard fight. She's got cancer. And we got to see her while we were in BC. She made me this, and she looks fucking fantastic. And she's consuming a lot of cannabis oil and trying to do a lot of healing. And all of our prayers are with Gail. Gail needs a little bit more than our prayers. There is a GoFundMe account that has been set up for Ted and Gail on, you know, the ultimate fight. They're fighting cancer. So we're asking everybody to come in support. And I believe Cris can probably put that website up. I do believe I provided the link for that. So there's a...
Yeah, it's a...
There you go.
That's it there.
There you go. That's
Gail.
And that's Ted.
Amazing people. You know, over 15 years ago, Ted... in Victoria, BC, was down there at the public library handing out medicated cookies as a protest and just giving them away to just about anybody who wanted them. He was, of course, arrested and He's been up, you know, many times. His club's been raided, but they're still there today. The Cannabis Buyers Club, one of the oldest clubs in Canada.
Yep. And if you've ever met Ted and Gail, they are two of the sweetest fucking people you will ever meet.
Yeah.
They will give you the shirt off their backs. And
these people deserve the help more than than anyone else I know right
now.
So
you know what? Even if it's only $5, if you've got a couple bucks to give and you really want to help the movement, if you want to know how you can help legalization, you help people that have fought for it. So I'm encouraging you guys to go check out the GoFundMe link. We will post that on our Facebook page as well, so you guys can go and pay homage to some true activists out there.
What's up?
Oh, we are. I figured we would have gotten to this story. That was the bong along on the script. Opus has asked me questions about our script, and it was like, we missed that a lot. We did that a long time ago. We're a little script tonight, folks.
Okay.
I figured it was kind of obvious.
All right. Do you want to do a...
Yeah.
What do you
want to do? We already played the promo, and that was from our friend at... that was our friend Ryan at Mailman Farms. Again, those were the guys that kept
that
us warm.
Oh, that was what that was. Okay, I know what that was.
Those guys kept us warm in Burke and BC while we were watching Baby Clouds get made. All right, so now...
CCHQ?
Yeah. We had an amazing time at CCHQ with Cris and Aaron Goodwin. They were there with us. We did our show last Monday from Cannabis Culture Headquarters.
That was fun.
That was fucking fun. And I want to thank every single staff member at Cannabis Culture Headquarters and the BCMP for being so welcoming and gracious to us. They were great. And they put on quite the production. And so... There was Cris and Aaron Goodwin were with us, and it was fun. And then K. Trevor Wilson from the CK podcast came, and he was actually a guest on our show, and everybody loved him. From what I've been hearing from all of our online viewers, they thought he was awesome.
Yeah, everyone likes K. Trev. It was pretty good. They were so very accommodating at CCHQ, even to the fact they let Cris and I... grab this huge easy chair from the third floor and kick a paying customer out of it in their lounge, and
so
then drag the chair downstairs, and like we move the poor guy over. He's all set up with his MacBook and his shit's all spread out. He's in that nice big comfy chair in the corner, and sorry, buddy, you got to move. And,
I'm pretty sure Jeremiah's instructions to Cris going upstairs were, you can take it as long as someone's not using it.
Oh, yeah.
<That's> just didn't
we threw that right
but
out the window.
Then it was great to see Greg use it on Wednesday's show, too. The set
and he
looked
loved
great.
It, too. Nobody
that chair's not going back upstairs.
It looked awesome.
You know that. Nobody's bringing that upstairs.
So like, such a great lounge setup for them.
We
so
go back next year, that chair will still be downstairs.
So that was Toronto's influence. Greg gets a new chair.
Yeah. So we kind of took over, but that was our intention, and we partied it up. And even back when I used to do my show out of CCHQ, they didn't let me give away weed there because it was like, oh no, we can't, you know.
Well, the issues with
they
Mark
have a
and
lot
everything.
Of issues because of Mark. But now that Mark was being released, because that was what we were there for, was Mark's release day party.
Well, we weren't there for that.
No, but that was
it wasn't.
Greg's show.
On Greg's show, yes. Yeah. But on our show, Greg's our show was 2 days previous.
2 days before,
Yeah. So that was the first time you've ever actually given away weed in that lounge.
Yeah, they never let me give away weed in that lounge. The only time I gave that game was born in this lounge when I came to visit in 2010.
Wow.
Ah.
See, I didn't know that.
I started that game here.
I didn't know that was the first time you'd given away weed at the BCMP.
I only because I couldn't do it there. So that's where it was good to come back to VC because I was able to give away marijuana. And speaking
that's
of
amazing.
Giving away marijuana.
We should give away some marijuana.
Do you want to give away marijuana?
Let's give away some marijuana.
Do you guys want to win marijuana?
Who wants to win some weed? Who wants to play How Much Does That Bud Weigh?
How many of you are asleep? Lots.
Yeah. See, like, dude, that's not a good question.
That's
we're
a
trying
question.
To hype them up, and
that's
you're asking
question.
Them if they're asleep. All right, fuckers, get your tickets out. Let's play How Much Does That Bud Weigh? All right, so we're going to pull two tickets, and we're going to pull two contestants.
Opus live on Pot TV.
Oh, we have a promo playing in the background. We missed it. So we're going to pull up two contestants. We got two tickets here.
I got a ticket. If your ticket ends in 914, come on up to the front. You're a contestant on How Much Does That Bud Weigh? Oh, look at this gentleman's right here, and he's on it.
On it, on it, on it, on it.
All right,
and
man,
what's your name, love?
What's your name, dude?
Delon.
Hey, Delon. Welcome to the show. You know how to play?
Yeah.
All right, hang on. I'm going to get another contestant here. All right.
Oh, someone ticket is commenting number. On
last three numbers on your ticket. 919. I've just been called a teenager.
919. Ticket 919. Come on up and play. How much All does right. that bud weigh?
Another contestant. I think it was a girl one, but she handed it off. She's like, no, no. Her boyfriend's much better at this.
Hey, sweetheart. You got to learn about weed because there are lots of awesome ticket. Stoner babes in this world.
Verification.
And you should be representing. You can hang out in a vapor lounge. You better know how much your bud weighs. Do not get ripped off. Do not. You need to know more because they're going to try to rip you off because you're a girl.
No.
All right. So.
Before we start to play, I want to mention the fact that what I have here are the official How Much Does This Bud Weigh ashtray scales, the secret scales. You see, you pull them off like this, they become scales, but looks like an ashtray.
And what's your name, my dear? Your name?
Jason.
And all right, just so you know, everybody knows, Opus is only the only person who's allowed to bring
That's
scales.
That's right.
You know what's funny about that? Ashtrays are actually illegal in here.
Ashtrays are illegal?
They are.
I didn't know that.
In any lounge, if it has that little divot for the cigarette, it's a $5,000 fine.
Oh, really?
I had no idea. Ontario Smoke Free Act.
So that's doubly illegal.
All right. Well, I'm the only one allowed to have this in the lounge, and only during the show, just so you know.
Yes.
So even after show, like when I'm here, not during the show, trust me, I do not have scales on me, so don't ask.
Fuck now. We're breaking two laws.
Right?
Oh, well. So now we're breaking two rules.
I'm breaking all the laws.
We have a scale.
I like to break the rules.
And an ashtray, and that's wrong.
So, anyways, you guys, you know how to play, Jason? You got to eyeball this weed in this bag, and you're going to tell me how much you think it weighs. And this is including the little bag, but you don't get to touch it. You can only eyeball it. So it's just by looking.
So you get to look at it?
And then you're going to write your answers down on the paper that Tracy's given you, in point of a gram. Are you going to show them to him?
I am closer to them, so yes, I am going to show it to them.
Then
we'll put it on the Bud Cam for everybody else at home so they can make their guesses as well. But for Bud Cam folks, there you go.
In the baggie?
Yeah, it's in the baggie. So we want to know how much does this bud weigh?
All right, gentlemen. Na 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 na.
Including the bag. I'm not emptying it out. No, I'm gonna weigh it in the bag. So, because you know, there you go. You gotta get
Sir.
He's looking over to his member, his buddy on the. He's looking over to the side. He's going, "What do you think, man? What do you think?"
All right, hold on. Let me hold it up for them a little bit more. Did you get it on the bud cam?
No, here.
There we go, our friends at home. Do we want to tell them what strain that is? Do we know?
It was a rock star.
So this is rock star, gentlemen. Rock star is the strain. All right, gentlemen. All right, gentlemen, I need your answers.
TikTok. There we go.
So
here we go.
Jason, you got to write them down. You got to hand
seconds.
That. Hold on, you got to. He's got the pen yet. Hold on, that's what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
So Jason will write down his answer, and he's got to hand that pen over to Delon, and I need those answers. All right, I got Jason's answer over here. Give that to me, my love. What are the online viewers saying, Cris? Do we know? Do we have our online chat open? Do we have any guesses? All right, Opus, do we know how much that bud weighs?
Well, let's see.
And the ashtray says, we've got comments from the peanut gallery over here, also known as the stoners who don't smoke swag.
And the official weight is?
Wait, I'll tell you what the guesses were. Nope. Tell me what the official weight was.
2.7 grams.
Oh, they're so off. So off.
Are we crazy? We got crazy ass guesses here?
Well, our friend Jason, he was very optimistic. He thought it was 5.2. So that's true. Our friend DeLon at 4.5 has guessed how much that bud weighed.
Yeah.
So you, my friend DeLon, have won cannabis.
That's right. You win the cannabis. But you want to know the best part? Is everybody who guesses really high, you go into my special list of people I want to sell pot to.
Oh, wait. What'd you say? Jason, where'd the sticker? I need a sticker for Jason. Where the sticker?
A sticker. Oh, wait, Jason.
Jason, we do have a little consolation prize from our trip to BC.
You got a very high quality sticker from the Herbal Health Center, the dispensary in Vernon, BC.
So, you know, stick it on your computer or your, you know, skateboard.
Stick it on a cop car.
I like to stick them on my filing cabinet. That's where I keep all of my stickers that people give me, my promo stuff. All right. So
I'll have to get my other scales back that don't look like an ashtray.
Yeah, because now you're breaking two rules.
Because I do have another pair. I think we'll switch this out. I had no idea the ashtray was illegal.
Yeah. All right.
But it's a pretend ashtray. If they could say, ha, fooled you. They're scales. It's not an ashtray.
So before we got to this, we were actually talking about what's going on with CCHQ. And that we were there with marijuana man himself, Greg Williams.
Greg Williams, marijuana man, yo.
And Greg was one of the BC3. He was one of the guys that was arrested with Marc Emery and Michelle K. Rainey. And he hosts a show on Wednesdays called Under the Influence with Marijuana Man, from Under the Influence. And he was really, really awesome. So he hosted a big party on his last day. Casey the coffee guy just came to get our order. And if anybody's online's been wondering, this is my giant Slurpee cup.
Tracy's got an industrial size Slurpee.
It's 99 cents to fill it once you buy the $7 cup.
Yeah.
No, I don't need it refilled, but maybe next show. Like, I didn't really like attack it this time, but I need a hotter day in Toronto.
Yeah, Tracy has the, yes. Break the machine Slurpee.
I explained the story of the Slurpee cup. I used to be in a relationship with this guy, and you know, if we got into a fight and it was my fault, I'd bake him cookies, and if it was his fault, he'd go buy me a slushie. So one day he really fucked up, that's how I got the slushie cup.
And what you know, and you never made cookies.
But I made lots of cookies. But one day he really fucked up, and I got the giant slushy cup. Just showed up at the door with it.
Let's
apology. But I wanted to get back because I wanted to get onto the next part of it. I wanted because I kind of want to talk about what happened with Greg.
Mark or Greg?
Well, it's kind of right. They blend into each other, which is why they're written that way.
And like carry it on here.
Because we were talking about that Greg hosted this party the last night we were at CCHQ. To celebrate Mark's last night in prison. And so they had they ordered pizza, which is what Mark was making all his cellies in his last night in prison. Mark had half an onion and 2 black market tomatoes. And I don't even want to think how you get 2 black market tomatoes through prison.
Prohibition tomatoes. And
like,
they weren't squished.
Like, thank God they weren't squished. But he had half an onion and 2 tomatoes. So Mark was making all his cellies pizza in prison on Wednesday night. So we ordered tomato and onion pizza.
Tomato and onion pizza.
From Michelangelo's on 420 Richard Street.
At 420 Richards. That's actually their address.
And when we opened up the pizza, there was actually a message from the guys at the pizza joint saying that they were really happy that Mark was coming home. And they were 420 friendly and congratulations. Which was really, really awesome. But they had this great party, and it was all, you know, great things because, you know, hey, Mark's coming home. And
it's pretty cool to see all the people at work at CCHQ. Like, there's like their painting and
oh yeah, that was great.
Cleaning
it was
every little nook and cranny, climbing up on ladders and dusting fixtures that probably haven't been dusted in a while.
It was really awesome because it looked like everybody was acting like, oh, look, Dad's coming home. Yeah. And it was such an awesome day to walk in there, and like today is the last day. It was really quite an experience to be there.
There was a real energy going on.
And I want to thank Greg for including us in that. That was an honor, just to be on the show for that last episode or that show. But and it was everybody was so gracious when we were there. But everybody's wondering. So people are wondering what's going on with Mark. Mark has been taken out of the facility where he was in Yazoo, Missouri.
Yeah,
and
he's gone
now,
from Yazoo.
He is now in a holding facility in Louisiana. And you want to go over the address?
Yeah, I'll give him this here. Let's. All right, if you want to know how to get a hold of Mark, or actually help Mark, you can. He needs phone cards, and if you'd like to donate to his commissary.
You can send U.S. money orders.
Yeah, he's in Louisiana right now.
He's in Louisiana deportation jail.
But the address is U.S. money orders to Marc Emery, and the number is 0790677710. The last numbers are 710.
Yeah, and that's Tensas Parish Detention Center, 8606 Highway 65, Waterproof, Louisiana, 713-75
USA.
So we'll post that online on our Facebook page as well. You can send books.
Yeah,
that's
up on mine. You can go on mine. It's up. It's also up on the Opus Live page.
That's what I said. The Facebook page. Yep.
Oh yeah. Oh okay.
All right,
you said you will post it. It's been posted.
So I spoke to Jody this afternoon.
Right.
So Mark will meet with his his immigration caseworker or his whatever tomorrow morning. The contact that they have at the consulate returns from vacation on Wednesday. So watch our page on Facebook, so the Opus Live page on Facebook, for updates on that.
Yeah.
But, you know, if you want to help out Mark, send him letters. He's got nothing. He's literally sitting in an empty cell because they wouldn't let him travel with anything. So anything he had in prison while he was there, he doesn't have. They will literally drop him off with the shirt on his back and the money in his pocket when they finally do drop him off in the middle of Windsor somewhere. But right now, while he's in this holding facility, he's got Jack. So if you can send him letters, drop a postcard, anything. We don't know. We're hoping it's only going to be about 10 days that he's there, but it could be as long as a month. So that's the news from Jody.
All right. What else do we got going on here?
Oh. All right, public service announcement. This is my public service announcement for the Toronto Transit Commission. All right, and Cris, you might be able to pull up at least one of the pictures here and just put it up. Because I went on a little tour of Vancouver because I actually had some time. I normally don't get any time to myself while I'm in Vancouver. To just kind of go hang out and visit friends. So I went to go visit an old friend of mine from high school, and I hopped on the transit and paid my $4 and went on something called a C-Bus, which took me from downtown Vancouver down by where Cannabis Culture was and took me across the water into North Vancouver for $4. Now, I've gone over to Toronto Island, which is $7. And it's cold, and it's wet, and it's not a very nice boat, and, you know, it smells, usually a lot of the time and everything else. This thing was beautiful. It was like a luxury fucking cruiser. And, you know, like, $4, got on, like, it pinged, it talked to me. I love the Vancouver transit system. Like, we actually went, at one point, we went on a little tour from down by where Cannabis Culture headquarters is, to Watermelon Licorice Parlor on Commercial Drive, and $2.75, and we got some licorice, we visited this cute little shop for a little while, and then hopped back on the bus and went back to Cannabis Culture on that same $2.75. They have the greatest transit system ever.
Well, it's just the time, stamped time on the transfer.
But
right?
That's
so
what
it's
I
good
loved
till
about it.
Same as our transfer. Isn't our transfer got a time limit on it, though? You can hop on and hop off?
No. You can't go from one line to, like, if the lines don't connect, if they're going in the Like
oh,
the same
back to the same way.
Same direction. Yeah,
oh,
no, okay. You can't do that here. So it doesn't work the same way.
Thank
here.
You to Casey the coffee guy. He's so a I've,
you
perfect.
Know,
I'm
you
glad
can't,
you're a little
yeah,
early,
you can't,
sir.
You can't go pick up your dry cleaning right. And then use the same transfer.
All right, I'm going to step in here because you're going way too fast today.
Oh, you're I'm just, going way too fast.
Because you're just whipping in through stories and, like,
I
you
got
to slow down, Tracy. Please. Please and thank you. Because it's only 8 o'clock. We're covering almost everything. You just ran through every story.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes,
can you,
you
tell
did.
We've spent 10 days together? Can you tell?
Well, Trey, look, go watch the film. Go watch the video.
Yes. That's fine. Listen. All right.
All right.
So we still got other things to talk about.
We do. Actually,
we do.
Let's talk
we've
about...
We've lots of things to talk about.
I know. All right. I want to go on to the Vernon Health Center.
Yeah.
And our
which was supposed to be just after. Yes, I understand. Let's go on to the Vernon right. Health Center.
All right. So
I got this
hello.
Great message from this woman named Donna Jo.
Oh, for fuck's sakes. I was taught. Let me talk.
Okay.
Stop. Please. Stop.
Do you want me to cut your mic, Tracy?
Yeah, cut her mic. Because I've had enough. She just won't stop.
I agree.
Let me get a word in. Thank you. Good Lord. All right. So we went to Vernon, and the reason I went there was, we went there, was for my daughter's wedding, and which was a marvelous time. And while we were there, I posted up, and so did Tracy, location. I was checking in using the location status on Facebook quite often. So, yes, Tracy did get messaged. By Donna Jo, a lovely person. And look at now she's miffed. She's packing up.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just kind of wanted to say how we had gotten to the Vernon Health Center.
I know.
But apparently...
Well, I know. I just asked you for a chance to talk a little bit too, Tracy. That's all. You've been just running through every story.
I'm sorry.
This is called Opus Live.
This is Opus Live.
I get it.
You're
seriously,
just running off with
no,
the show.
No.
I'm sorry. I was just trying to follow the storyline.
I know, but
I
you're running through the show, and I'm taking my show back.
Yeah, he just wants more back and forth and
I'm
more
sorry.
Opus.
I'm taking the show back.
I'm sorry. I was just trying to follow okay.
You could see he was trying to get his word in a few times.
I'm having to fight with you over getting time in here, and that's not right. So we're setting this straight. I accept your apology.
I'm just... Why don't you talk about the Herbal Health Center? And I'm going to go out, and I'm going to go have a cigarette.
Go have a smoke.
And you can go talk all you like. How's that?
Okay. There we go. Anyhow, at the Herbal Health Center. Sorry, we're going to play video, and you're talking in those.
It's okay. I'll stay away longer. It's okay.
We were... invited down to the Herbal Health Center, and we decided to post that we were going to have a wake and bake down there. And so we did, and we went in, and we were introduced by this lovely lady, Donna Jo, who Tracy had hooked up with. Oh, there we go. And she was pretty cool. We went in. At first, it was a little bit unnerving because we approached them with, like, cameras, and, you know, we're kind of walking in. We got... I think I was wearing this shirt. Tracy had on an Opus Live shirt. So we're probably a little intimidating. An excellent facility. They've got a vapor lounge in back for their patients, as well as a very, very extensive line of medication. They had a number of oils, and I believe they had some salves. Cris, if you want to run one of those the videos, how about we look at first? We'll look at Tracy and Ben. Ben is one of the, I guess he's one of the owners, one of the organizers of the works there, managers of the facility. Check this out.
Hey, it's Tracy. You're watching Opus Live, and we're here at the Herbal Health Center in Vernon, BC, with Ben checking out their awesome dispensary and vapor lounge. And Ben, can you tell us about what kind of services you offer patients here?
Yeah, for sure. The Herbal Health Center is a full-service medical cannabis dispensary. Our mission statement here is to provide the highest quality cannabis products that we can to patients who require them. whether that's somebody who's coming to us for cancer therapy using the dark cannabis oils, if we're providing a CBD-rich formula to someone who suffers from seizures or an epileptic kind of situation. We're here to serve the community, and we do that in an open and in a very transparent sort of format. We've been allowed to do this by the city of Vernon, and seize the day.
Yeah, they've offered you guys an actual business license. You guys operate here. You're able to call the police when you have problems with people that have alcohol.
Yeah.
Issues that you have harassment by issues that you have to deal with, which is great. And you guys are actually celebrating your 1 year anniversary here next week.
Yeah, you betcha. We've got our 1 year anniversary coming up on the 20th of July. And we're going to have a big tent outside. There's live music. We'll be having a barbecue. Of course, we'll have some heavily discounted products. And we've got some giveaways as well from some of our suppliers and some of our sponsors here.
That's awesome. So if you're in Vernon and you need access to medical marijuana, you should check out the Herbal Health Center. Or maybe come by next week and check out their 1 year anniversary. Check them out, and thanks for visiting.
And where are we exactly? What's the address here?
The address here, we're on Kalamalka Lake Road. This is the Alpine Business Center. If you want to have a look further, we've got a website as well, www.thhc.ca.
Awesome. So thanks a lot, Ben. And, you know, we'll catch you later back in Toronto. Keep watching Opus Live and Cultivate Your Freedom.
Yeah, that was Ben, and he was the individual who met us at the door. And kind of after we talked to him and explained who we were and what we were kind of trying to do, promote the normalization and the good things that they're doing there, and to show other people what's going on in different parts of the world. How he was funny. He's like, okay, I have to go in the back and unruffle my partner's feathers. And that was kind of funny. But one of the other staff members who commented afterwards on a post in Facebook mentioned that rocky start, stellar finish. And the next video we're gonna put up is actually Tracy and Selena. Selena was a lovely young girl, worker there, and clearly you'll see by the video she's extremely passionate about what she does, and she really believes in the cause and using cannabis as medicine. And so watch this. Tracy and Selena.
Hi, it's Tracy. You're watching Opus Live on Pot TV. We're here with Selena at the Herbal Health Center in Vernon, BC, and an awesome dispensary vapor lounge. Selena, how do you help people here?
We help people in a lot of different ways. First and foremost, what we do is we connect with people. So we hear their story, we listen, we want to help them through education. So one of the biggest things that we do here is we empower people to make choices about their next step with their health and wellness.
So they get to be proactive in their healthcare as opposed to being told that this is what you're going to do.
Exactly.
Yeah, they take charge. That's awesome. And how many strains? There's a lot of strains on the wall behind you. How many strains do you think you're carrying right now?
Right now, anywhere between 25 and 30 strains.
And is that the average here
at
the
Anywhere between 25 and 35 at any given time.
And can you show us some of these other things you have here, some of these?
We do have a whole bunch of different kinds of keef, pressed hash. I think one of the most beneficial things that we actually have on our shelves is the CBD. So this is cannabidiol. This is a non-psychoactive way that people can medicate, reduce inflammation, help themselves with pain, anxiety, psychosis, muscle spasms, as well as protect their brain. So this is one of the best things I think we have. So this is CBD capsules. We've also got dark oil that's been integrated into pill form for people. So if someone's wanting to start ingesting dark oil, but they've already got a regime that they're comfortable with, this is a way that people can consistently dose for themselves. It's also great for blister packs. So a lot of our members, they are over the age of 55. We do have a large senior population. So within their doctors, working within that realm, we're able to help them that way too. We do have a whole bunch of different types of dark oil, as well as amber, cherry oil, and honey oil. Our honey oil is gorgeous. I don't know if you want to see this.
Yeah, let's have a look.
Take a look at that.
Oh, wow.
Now that is produced by one of our owners, and that is consistent, beautiful. He makes that here in the Okanagan Valley.
That's beautiful.
Yes. Other than that, We do have a whole host of different types of tinctures. We've got ones that are suspended in alcohol, ones that are suspended in glycerin. I personally really like the glycerin that's cold pressed. This again is non-psychoactive, so this is a great way for people to medicate during the day if they've got pain, anxiety, nausea, things like that. They can medicate, they can go to work, and they don't have to worry about feeling weird. Also with the cold pressed glycerin tinctures, you can use those for animals, for example. I know that we've got several members that are animals. We've got ones that have glaucoma, ones that are arthritic.
Did you say several members that are animals?
Yes.
That's awesome. That is awesome.
Now, are they signed over from their vet?
They're signed over from a naturopath in town, yes.
Oh, that's amazing.
From a natural, that is so cool.
That's amazing.
I really like that.
I do too.
So, Selena, thank you so much for kind of giving us the tour of the Herbal Health Center here in Vernon, BC. And check us out on Pot TV.
Absolutely.
And keep cultivating your freedom.
Cultivate your freedom.
Cultivate your freedom.
Thank you.
Yeah, those guys most certainly are cultivating freedom in Vernon. And if you know anything about... Vernon, British Columbia. It's in the Okanagan Valley, which is a very, very conservative stronghold and religious part of British Columbia. It's known as part of the Bible Belt. And for one, pardon? Mennonite. Yeah, they. Oh yeah, there's Mennonites there, and very straight community. But
that girl was cute too.
Yeah, yeah. No, she was very lovely, lovely young lady. And yeah, but you can just see the passion in her. She's dead serious. Like, she really is there to work and do her shit. Like, she's not farting around there. All the people there are really dedicated. It was a very clean run operation. We have a lot of photos of that. That I know Tracy was trying to upload some, but was having difficulty getting it done from her tablet. But yeah, there's actually quite, there's more than one dispensary. There's actually a few other dispensaries in town that we heard of. This one is a little more professionally and cleanly run. I guess there's a couple places where it's like, yeah, man, what's wrong? You got a problem? Okay, you know. They just kind of sell you weed, or so we were told. We didn't actually get to visit those ones. But, you know, consider, I used to live in Vernon quite a few years ago, and I was shocked to see that there's that much acceptance in that area towards medical marijuana and marijuana in general. So even in, you know, a very conservative stronghold like that, where they it's always been voted conservative. It's interesting to see. Pot took a foothold. So I think I should probably give away a subscription to Skunk Magazine. Does anybody want to win the subscription to Skunk Magazine? Meh, no. Sure you do. It's great reading. Oh, here comes Erin. She's got more ticket stubs. Somebody else is going to get in on this draw. Right? Oh, yeah, we're going to shake it up. Shake it up good. Here, sit down. Why don't you sit down and join me? Tracy's out smoking.
Every week, someone wins a full year subscription to Skunk Magazine on Opus Live.
That's right.
It's a great sponsor.
That's pretty cool. Pretty nice sponsorship they stepped up.
Didn't you say somebody came up and said they got
someone
their subscription,
did.
But they were wondering when the next issue is going to come
well,
now?
No,
they're so
no,
excited
they
about it.
Someone asked, they won last month, and they so they won sometime in June, and they haven't gotten the July issue.
I don't think they publish monthly.
So how often is it published?
I'm not sure. I think it's bi-monthly.
Bi-monthly.
I think it's maybe 6 issues a year.
Okay.
Yeah. But I'm not positive about that. You want to draw?
Oh, wow. So with someone with the last three numbers, 944.
944. You got those last number the last three numbers on your ticket are 944?
That was fun.
Well, yeah, I heard something in the back. It sounded like, was that a bong rip or somebody winning?
If someone doesn't come to claim this, then we'll have to draw another ticket.
Yeah.
And they'll miss out if they're outside smoking or something.
Calling once, going twice.
Yeah, 944.
No, loser. They're not, unless they're in the bathroom, no.
All right.
All right. Tracy's back here. Maybe she'll have Tracy will have better luck.
I was out having a cigarette with one of our sponsors.
One of our sponsors. Uh-oh.
I was looking forward to having shoes to winter.
I have two.
Would that be...
I have two, which I did not... I actually have to show one of our sponsors some photos of something we found.
Oh, when, yes. I know who it was. Vancouver. Yeah, that's what I was going to ask.
Ticket, 941.
941. Probably sitting beside 944.
941. You have one yearly subscription to Skunk Magazine.
How many issues are in a year subscription, Tracy?
I believe it is, I think it's six issues.
So
it
every other month.
I think it's every
month.
Because
one of the previous winners was asking when they should expect their first.
But then they do special issues as well, so I think it actually might be more.
Like seven or eight or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
But
best of or...
Yes. Ticket 941 going once. 941 going twice.
Is someone making their way up?
Anyone?
Nope.
Anyone? Do I have
Nobody.
A winner?
All right.
Girl. All right.
Take another one.
All right.
Take
third time's a charm. Exactly. Great minds think alike. And the third ticket is ticket 943.
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Here.
943.
The last three picks have been within four numbers of each other. That's craziness.
I shook it, but I guess they like.
No, but like I picked from different corners of the jar.
How about 923? Anybody got 923?
923 going once.
Oh, man.
Oh. Do we have somebody? Do we have 923? We have a winner. Sir, what is your name?
Daniel,
congratulations. You have won a yearly subscription to Skunk Magazine. And whatever, there are other people, the lovely owners of
Just
Pure
give,
Garden Resort and the Grill.
Aaron up there, your mailing address particulars, where you want it sent to, and we'll send it off to the people and they'll get your subscription.
All right.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah.
Congrats. Thanks for playing and thanks for coming to Opus Live. And thank you, Skunk Magazine and the Pure Garden Resort Negril in Negril, Jamaica. Part of the Skunk Network and great place to stay if you're thinking of going to Jamaica. We do the activist retreat there, and it's a great place to stay. So, check it out. All right, what else? Oh, we have one more thing that we have to give weed away for another sponsor. Oh, but you want to mention, do we have the photos or what's the story?
In like 10 minutes we'll do that.
All right. What's the story on your photos for our other sponsor you were smoking with, you mentioned?
Oh, no, I'll have to do...
You don't have that, no?
No.
Oh, okay. All right, you want to show us some Douglas Copeland? Talk about that?
Oh, I could, yeah. You were at the exhibit, so it's there. You can talk about it. It's fine.
Well, you're the one. Actually, you took me. You brought me there. Actually, Tracy was kind enough.
Tracy was kind enough
to bring me. You were going to use me as an example. Actually, that's why I asked if you wanted to do that.
Well, it's a little bit. Yeah.
All right.
Let me see. So how many? So this is kind of a little. Usually we do stoner etiquette. So this is a little all around stoner etiquette. We're just going to talk about the stoner cult and culture. Not going to talk about stoner culture. We're going to talk about stoners and culture. So how many times have you been to events at the Vancouver Art Gallery, Opus?
At least a dozen events at the Vancouver Art Gallery. Outside the Vancouver Art Gallery.
And how many times have you walked inside the Vancouver Art Gallery, Opus, and actually gone to look at the art?
I was going to say, including using the bathroom? No, I guess not. No, that would have been zero.
So, I walked by the Vancouver Art Gallery. We walked by the Vancouver Art Gallery one day, and I saw this great big poster outside that said the Douglas Copeland exhibit. Now, if you guys don't know who Douglas Copeland is, he is this amazing Canadian author and visual artist. He's written great books like Generation X, Micro Surfs, J-Pod, and All Families Are Psychotic, to name a few of my favorites. And he had this great exhibit at the Vancouver Art Gallery. Know exactly where my little flyers went, but called Everything Is Anything and Everything Is Everywhere. And it was this great exhibit Let me see. It's like kind of a mind-blowing, face-melting exhibit. Like it just, it literally, that's the description of it. It pays homage to Canadian culture and like all his common themes. Like his common themes are kind of like, he does like this whole like postmodern religion and
urban
2.0 techno stuff. Well, his written stuff is usually a lot, like there's a lot of human sexuality and postmodern technology and postmodern religion. Like it's just, it's his stuff is really great. My favorite piece was just this box. And I'll post pictures on the Opus Live Facebook page. If anybody wants to check it, I'll post a couple pictures up there. But my favorite piece was this box made out of old highway signs, you know, Thunder Bay and Kappa's Casing and all these places. And it was just a plaster cast of a leg. And you looked at it, if you're Canadian, it only took you like a few seconds to actually look at it and realize what it was homage to Terry Fox, which is usually all those highway signs with the statue of Terry Fox with the fake leg. And instead what they did was they paid homage to the leg. Douglas Copeland showed the leg that he'd lost.
The leg he didn't have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how much, you know, that kind of, that whole thing was.
That jumped right out. I thought, Terry Fox thing?
And there was another exhibit which was called The World and it was all made out of Lego and all of these pieces and this crazy giant piece of art. And then you looked inside and there were cameras everywhere because of course the world is watching. Douglas Copeland is brilliant, and if it runs until September 1st, if you are near the Vancouver Art Gallery, you should definitely check it out.
I highly recommend it.
You should definitely read a couple of his books. He's an awesome Canadian author. And stoners, if you are gonna have your rallies outside a museum or a library or a cultural center, go the fuck inside and learn something. It's not just the cannabis culture. It's go out and experience culture when you're high. Tell me that exhibit was not fucking awesome.
It was totally awesome. And, I got cultured. It was great. I actually got to see the inside of the place. What about the weather room?
Oh, yeah. There was...
That was insane. There was this room that you went in, and basically there is a thunderstorm passing overhead. They had like buckets on the floor, stains in the ceiling, like you could hear the leaking, but there actually wasn't. But there's rain on the outside that's plastering the windows, thunder, lightning flashes. You actually, at the lights inside the room like flicker on and off, like there's a power failure and stuff. You stood in there for, I don't know, like 15 minutes or something like that. It was like Tracy says, I want one of these rooms. I'm like, yeah. The totally coolest thing I've ever seen, one of them. That was really neat.
Yep, I want a storm room.
A thunderstorm room.
Yep.
It even had like humidity in it. It was humid and like they had jacked up inside the humidity somehow. And yeah.
Yep.
That was cool.
Do you have the Fumo pipe video?
The Fumo pipe video. Can you find, when we play that?
Yeah, because we haven't talked about that. We wanted to go back to the LaFumo stuff. Because that was
LaFumo demo video.
That hasn't been played yet. And
I was going to mention the price of the tickets for the raffle.
So if you want to actually get a chance to buy this awesome LaFumo pipe or win this LaFumo pipe, it's all the proceeds are going to patients who are fighting the new regulations being put out by the government that will take away their rights to grow. This pipe will turn any bong that you own into a dabbing unit. Oh, well, we'll turn most, I guess, most bongs you own into a dab unit. And so Opus will describe how it works while Cris looks for the video.
Actually, we're going to just play a video here, and you'll see exactly how it works on the video, so just hang tough. And I'll just leave that on the bud cam for a minute, and you're going to look. Check this video out.
So this is the Kush lady, and we'll just call this guy the Fumo guy, for all intents and purposes. And you're witnessing a domeless nail piece. The first ever in the world,
the
I believe,
piece on
correct?
The end of this one?
That's the first one on an indestructible piece. That's right, my brother.
completely and totally indestructible.
Let me show you why. Watch this shit. Oh shit, it didn't break. What the fuck? Let's keep torching. Yeah. You gotta love that now. Unless you do that with your fucking bomb, you'll be crying to your mama. That's what it's all about. One time investment. You can flip up the nail upside down, right side up. I don't care, I just need to medicate. And as you can tell, my sister here, they got quality meds, and we're gonna do some of their wax. So, as my brother, Alfredo, Master Yoda up there in Cali says, wax on, wax off, cabrones. So I'm gonna show you guys. All right, here we go. That should be nice, ready to go. And we're gonna take a little dabber.
Demo stab. Instant.
So nice. That little button's like a shotgun choke.
So.
And one of the nice things, inside this metal piece, even if you're using it for a for flowers and using the flower ball, there's actually like a the design of it. It's works like a cooling chamber, and it significantly cools any smoke that you're pulling down through it. And as well, it doesn't get hot, which is interesting. Now, I'm pretty sure you can take this off. I'm not going to, but the this glass piece. Our friend Tim, or it might be plastic, or yeah, I think it's plexi or some kind of Lexan. But our friend Tim had an interesting one. He had like a 3.5 foot one on there during the Champs Expo, and he was walking around threatening comics.
4 feet.
Or 4 feet
he was
long.
Actually 4 feet
yeah,
long.
Yeah, so he was threatening comics at the Underground Comedy Club with it one night, and that was a whole other story and a show in itself. Do a dab. And
yep.
With this 4 foot long dab unit just like hitting the button and, you know, getting comics all fucked up on stage. It was hilarious.
Yeah, I think they ruined a few careers in comedy. I think they feel guilty.
One guy left and quit comedy.
I don't think that's actually true.
Yeah, I don't. Well, he did leave.
He did leave, but I think he actually went to another club that just had drunk people in it where they laughed.
Yeah, he went to a club where he could succeed. I don't know if he was dabbed. He might have gone there and fell asleep.
I'd like to thank you, my lovely friend, who just brought me this fabulous, yummy joint. It's very good. I love it. Filtered and all. Thank you.
Very nice.
I love, you know, I love it when people.
That's from one of our sometimes sponsor there. Who cares? Get doped. We got
we could actually show the photos, but just so he knows, while we were out on Slushy Day on 7-Eleven's birthday in Vancouver, of all places, we found some Who Cares Get Dope stickers in various spots around Vancouver.
Somebody
while we were on our walk around Vancouver.
Somebody was slapping up Who Cares Got Dope slaps in Vancouver.
Yeah, we found them as we were walking. And so there, you know, there is a Who Cares Get Dope stickers all over Vancouver. So, you know, yay to our yay to one of those awesome sponsors out there. The Bong Man Cruise.
Oh, and also, by the way, I want to mention about Vancouver. Walking around with a Justin Trudeau zigzag shirt on gets you a shitload of looks in Vancouver. I guess they're not used to seeing them there.
I've been noticing more and more Justin Trudeau shirts out west. That's weird.
Just when we were walking around at Davie and Denman there at the near English Bay, like, all kinds of people were walking by and going, hey, man, you know, looking at me, giving me a thumbs up or a nod, like, smile, like, yeah, yeah, you know.
I got a lot of likes when I wore mine to the glass gathering.
Yeah.
I'm just going to go to a quick video.
Really popular.
I watch Opus Live on Pot TV.
Jody. That's Jody. She's awesome.
Yeah, that's Jody. She's a member of the lounge or the Herbal Health Center in Vernon. Gesundheit. Sneezy weed. Hey, so we should maybe give some marijuana away online?
Oh, how much does that bud weigh online?
Yeah, let's for budbuddy.biz, one of our other sponsors that we need to honor and thank very much for stepping up and sponsoring the show, the Opus Live show. I appreciate that very much. Hey, Aaron.
I think last week one of the online winners was in the room, like on one of their mobile devices and won.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, what, last week?
Yeah, I think so.
No, actually, I know.
Oh, no.
It's horrible. I actually know who won.
But they weren't in the room?
They weren't in the room, but they were in North Vancouver. It was a guy I went to high school with.
Because he was like, can't I just tell Tracy?
Because he was like, what are you doing? And I'm like, I'm about to do my podcast from Cannabis Culture headquarters. He's like, what podcast? And so I told him, and he was watching, and he won. And then he texted me. He's like, I asked him, can you pick up the bud for me? And I'm like, no, we'll have to get your mailing address.
That's cool.
But yeah, no, it was really, really funny because we're in the middle of the show, and he's like, I get this message going, I'm Billy Bob.
One of my friends actually won in the audience. He got to come up and be a contestant, and he won during the Wolfie.
Yeah. Oh yes.
That was awesome.
Yeah. That's cool.
He was one of my buds who invited down, and he was like, oh yeah. I was like, right on, you know. And sort of a guy I kind of haven't really known for a while, but never just met recently. So that was kind of fun.
Oh, and I have to give a shout out to a couple friends in Vancouver too. A buddy of mine from high school and his son started watching last week, and so hopefully they're watching again. So a shout out to Jay and Ty. Thanks for the hospitality, and I hope you guys are settling into your new home in Vancouver really well.
I'll see you guys again soon.
Yeah, I'm just trying to make sure it's framed.
Looks good.
Cool.
But all right, so this is the online Bud Buddy version of how much does this bud weigh? You got like 1 minute to start voting.
All right, for the online voters, you must have a mailing address that is not in the United States. And, oh, I'll put in something. Here, what can I put in? Here, how about this lighter? There you go. Thank you.
And that's a full-size Bic, people, if you're wondering.
Yes.
It's a full-size Bic.
Oh, Jack Drack already voted twice or three to... Oh, no, never mind. He's just trying to say he meant 3.7.
Oh, I see. He's changing his
mind. Okay, so one vote each, guys.
One vote each.
Now, I know there was an issue.
As soon as you put your vote up, that constitutes taking your hand off the piece.
No, somebody did report to me that a couple weeks ago, one of our winners had voted twice. And I get that we try to catch them. But please, guys, only one vote. It just clogs it up too much if you guys vote more than once.
That's it. All right. So we probably have run out of time on that.
I wish I had the song playing, but five more seconds. Four, three, two, one. Last vote, anybody? That's it.
And the voting is closed.
So, yeah, we had lots of votes.
This is the... I'll use 3.4,
2.4, 3, 7... 3.7, actually.
And how much does that butt of Heisenberg weigh, Opus? That would be a 3.8.
You said somebody voted 3.7. Somebody is like 1/10 of a gram off.
Jack Drack.
Actually, it's back and forth. It actually is 3.7. Because it was before I moved it towards Tracy. And
well, then
it,
you should have just said what it was.
I thought it was going to. I wanted to see where it would balance out. So, 3.7 is the weight. So I think we have an exact winner on the show today. But that Jack Drack, he's always on.
Oh, he's pretty good.
He's really good.
He's pretty good. And I bet, well, he probably knew it was Heisenberg because it was coming out of my jar. So that was like, I didn't even tell them the strain this time.
That's the powers of observation. See, he's paying it. I know Jack. He would be paying attention.
All right. Congratulations, Jack Drack.
And thank you, budbuddy.biz.
You need to send your mailing address to vaporcentral@gmail.com.
Yep. And they'll hook you up with budbuddy.biz once again. Thank you. All right. What else we got? Oh, the boat cruise. Do you guys, Are you selling tickets here, Cris? To Bong Man's boat cruise? There is tickets here.
Yeah.
And there, how many? Is there any available?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's on August 23rd. Bong Man's boat cruise. That would be at. That's an evening cruise this time around, isn't it?
How much are they, Cris? They're $60. Okay. Yeah, I believe it's an evening cruise. I don't know any of the details about it because obviously we're just finding out if the tickets are available here. So tickets are available at Vapor Central for the Bong Man Boat Cruise, April 23rd. $60.
$60, yeah. Well, I know before we went away, there was some talk about the tickets being here then, but they weren't, so that's why I brought that up. Lately on Facebook, there's been... a lot of anti-Trudeau kind of mania being stirred up. Then they're connecting it directly to Marc Emery, the Prince of Pot, and I guess trying to tie it into Jody Emery and Justin Trudeau. Put out by the Conservative Party, and there's like the meme sort of that said Marc Emery, or no, it was Justin Trudeau in over his head, like and share. If you think so, you might have seen that floating around. And there's another one. Do you remember what the other one was?
Well, there's been a lot of stories about, you know, Jody Emery being Trudeau's secret weapon and how it's bad for the party. And there is a lot of backlash about Marc Emery publicly saying that he's going to tour and stand and promote the Liberal Party. They're trying to kind of... There's a little separatism within the party itself, even. It's kind of like a come here, go away, come here, go away, come here, go away going on. There are some people within Vancouver that have courted Jody and asked her to run for a nomination in Libby Davies' riding.
Yep.
Mark has publicly said that he's going to support the Liberal Party. And the Liberal Party has kind of come back and said, we'll see. And the media is playing with it. Like, I actually watched a piece the other day that said, you know, that Jody Emery would be bad. You know, she'd be kind of a disaster.
Yeah, she's getting a lot
of... And I don't think that's fair because Jody is, you know, for whatever Mark has said, mm-hmm. Jody has always been eloquent. She has been, I mean, her approval rating must be through the roof when she does her show in Vancouver.
Yeah, she's on Global she does a show on Global she's picked up on all kinds of media.
That like she has done hordes so of media. Much media. She was doing Chinese news.
Yeah.
When we were leaving Vancouver, they were explaining to her how they were going to translate through the host of the show and how they would then answer and how she would have to be able to give short sound bites because it would be difficult for them to translate long answers.
I think she said 60 interviews in 4 days or 5 days or something crazy.
Insane. She'd had something nuts. Like maybe five hours sleep over 4 days. Like it was just that she's run ragged, and it's kind of like, and it's so hard because you want to tell her that, you know, hey, it's almost over, and it's just like it's just, yeah, like I told her, I said, you know, the great thing is that the next time I see her, she'll be with her husband. But, you know,
that's good for us.
It's, you know, but, you know, good, you know, it's like, you know, like I gave her a hug and that's all I could say. I was like, you know, hey, like, you know, hey, the next time I see you, you'll be with your husband. And, you know, she's like, that's amazing. You know, it's incredible, isn't it? And I'm like, it really is. And so.
Well, it is. I can't believe it. Mark's almost home.
But, oh, my God, I can't imagine being like, you know, Mark himself, like I said, he's stuck in a prison. He's got nothing with him. So seriously, people. You want to know what you can do for activism, what you can do in the pot movement? Go online, get the address, and drop a fucking postcard in the mail tomorrow.
Yeah, check out freemark.ca.
Just say, thinking about you, and drop it in the fucking mail. Because, you know, any thought from home right now when he is so close and yet so far away,
yeah.
I bet you will mean a lot.
These last few days have got to be the longest days. Like this, every day is, you know, every hour at this time is probably like three times longer than any other hour he's ever spent in the sentence.
And because now it's unknown. Yeah. Now it's in the hands of bureaucracy. And if you've ever been in the hands of bureaucracy, you know that fucking sucks, and it's a long, slow, torturous process.
So step the fuck up. Come on, it's not hard. Go to freemark.ca. All the information is there. We're going to get it up on the Opus Live page. Yeah. I'm going to have it on my Facebook page. Tracy, I'm sure, will, you know, share that up as well.
Of course.
It'll be all over the place. So it isn't hard to just, you know, send something along, some books or something from Amazon. And
yeah, but even if, you know, even if you can't do that.
A little bit of money.
Money for commissary. We're hoping he's not going to, you know, Jody's, they're all hoping he's not going to be in there for very long. But, you know, again, it's the unknown. The average is 10 days. He's already been technically free for four.
Yeah.
Thursday, he was free Thursday, so Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, four days.
He's already,
you know, he's already been in technically a free man for 4 days, and so let's see how much longer it
and,
takes.
And I guess we're going to hear back soon. You'll hear back from Jody when about what Mark happened with his meeting with his.
He meets with his, I guess it's an immigration caseworker. It's ICE.
ICE.
I don't know exactly what ICE means.
Immigration case.
Whatever. I'm not exactly sure what that means, but I'm sure it has something to do with immigration because he's in an immigration center in Louisiana.
It's a deportation jail or something, I think they called it.
Well, the crazy thing is I was talking to my neighbor today, and apparently he's got a friend that's in the same facility as Mark.
Really?
Yeah. not sure, but I guess there's different sections and different departments or whatever else. But he's in the same holding facility, so he very well might be coming back through with Mark. We're not sure. It's kind of the crazy story about all that. But like I said, Jody, he meets with his ICE worker tomorrow morning. And the person that they have contact with at the consulate comes back from their vacation Wednesday morning. So Mark will have more answers on Tuesday. Hopefully Jody will have more answers on Wednesday.
Yeah.
But the paperwork has been found, and it's waiting, and it's ready, and things are starting to move again.
Yeah, and hopefully as soon as Jody and the Cannabis Culture folks, good folks there, have the info, they're going to put up a phone number that we'll be able to call somebody, I guess, and once we have the right information of who we can politely pressure with phone calls.
Well, it's not even that. Apparently, at some point, that when he gets to the center, there should be a phone number available where you can call and leave a message for Mark, and they have to deliver it.
Oh, I see.
So I know they're waiting for that phone number too, because it would be great if we could all call and leave messages
and
as
leave
well,
a
and
message.
make them run them.
Oh, that would be funny.
you know, because I think at that point he just becomes a pain in the ass, and they want to send him home, right?
That's true.
So,
that actually happened at one of the facilities, I think, in Washington State. While they were processing him, they were getting a little pissed off at the amount of mail that Mark was actually getting, and this was when he was first taken across the border. They were like, yeah, at one point there was some disgruntlement on the amount of mail they had to read, because they had to read it all.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
well, and
censor
wondered,
it, what if
I've,
necessary.
I've wondered about that too, like, and in one of my letters from Mark, he told me how many letters he had received since he'd been in prison, and it's a lot. But then when you realize how much time he's spent in prison,
it's not that much. No.
Because he's got, you know, limited time. To do other things, like, you know, if you're stuck in your cell, if you don't have books, and luckily, you know, Mark did, he had people that sent him books and stuff like that. He was doing a lot of reading, and he had the opportunity to play in a band.
Learn a musical instrument. So, yeah, he's done a ton of reading, and I think there's been some writing, some book stuff, notes, I'm sure, and things he's done.
Is that a pot leaf guitar? Is that a bass?
I believe it is.
In the lounge?
But I'm not sure. I can't quote me on that, but I think so.
So do you think he's going to play it?
Probably.
I think that would be kind of cool to see Marc Emery play that. Like, my favorite photo in the lounge, there's this great photo of Jody Emery, and you should go on and Google it, Jody Emery and Tommy Chong. There's this fabulous photo from years and years ago of Jody taking a bong hit with Tommy Chong playing
that guitar in the
background. Yeah. It's a beautiful photo, and it's blown up, and it's in the BCMP lounge.
They took that out back on the roof there.
Yeah, they took it out. Yeah, I was sitting out there and realized that that's where that photo was taken.
I figured, yep.
But, you know, that's one of my favorite photos. Is
there's Cal Post giving me the touchdown and kick is good sign.
Oh,
the kick is good. Yes.
I'm wondering, though, because, like, last Monday, Aaron and Cris and me and you and K-Trev were all in Vancouver. Did he feel like I feel bad. Like, he felt like the kid that was left out. Like,
how'd you like warming up for Opus Live?
We all ran away without him.
How'd you like warming up for Opus Live, buddy?
Did he feel abandoned?
All by yourself.
Like,
I missed you guys.
Hey,
it was weird not having you around.
Yeah, I love good seeing you, man. We had a great show with your co-host, K Trev.
Oh, good, good.
Oh, it was awesome, man. He was funny as hell. Everybody loved him, you know.
You're the only one.
Our show rocked.
And look, check it out. So we talked about the Douglas Copeland exhibit earlier.
Right.
And then right underneath is K Trev.
Oh, the comedy mix with Graham Clark and Chris. Ooh, that's a great lineup.
Hey. So, you know, I was like, because I was like all about checking out the Copeland exhibit. Then I look underneath and I'm like, K-Trev.
What's he wearing on his head? I like that he's under Copeland.
Yeah, he's under Copeland.
Yeah.
It looks like a bathing
brilliant
cap.
Brilliant genius.
It looks like a goofy bathing cap.
Yeah, he's wearing a backwards baseball hat, but I think it's like a painter's hat. I'm not sure. It kind of looks like a duck bill.
Yeah, he looks ridiculous.
Yeah, he does. Do you want to keep it?
No. I have to look at him all the time.
But the show
was great opening for you guys. It was different.
Oh, yeah.
Very different, but we started a half hour earlier here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a fun time. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, good.
I prefer going after you guys.
Yeah, I do.
I like getting all the smart stuff out of the way first. Then I can come up and talk about tits.
Then we can just have debauchery and mayhem afterwards.
I'm a late night guy. It's where it fits.
There you go.
Well, it works good. Well, see, it's not all smart stuff. I had to bitch about the Copeland exhibit was awesome. I had to explain to Opus had been to at least a dozen protests outside the Vancouver Art Gallery, but had never actually gone inside.
Never set foot inside ever once. Big, huge. You see the side. Every time I'm there, too, like, that poster is on the side where we have our stage. So it's behind the stage. It's like, you know, I don't know what, 4 stories tall and it's a football field wide or something. It's retarded sign. Always promoting whatever exhibit's in there. Oh, wow, that's a cool painting.
Every time I come in here,
I saw that outside the wall. I saw the poster. It was like, yeah, that's cool.
Every time I come in here, I catch about half of your guys' show. And as soon as I walk in, you guys are in something deep. I'm like, fuck, I'm an idiot. I'm so goddamn stupid. I have no idea what the fuck they're talking about. And then in my brain, I got to go, hey, it doesn't matter. It's all futile anyway.
That's all right.
That's my first bit of culture ever.
Hopefully you only caught the last half, the good part of the show this week. Just walk in.
Well, every time I come in, too, it's like they were slamming you off the top. It's like, that's what the first half of the show is, right? Because you know I'm not going to be here yet.
That's right, yeah. We get all that out of the way.
Always.
Anyway, I'll let you guys close it up.
All right.
Enjoy.
Yeah.
All right, man.
So, if you're watching online, you should stick around and watch the CK podcast, minus the K. Apparently, he is away, still in Vancouver, doing awesome.
He's away for, I think, a couple more weeks, he told us. But it'll be Kyle Post and his guests, whoever he has lined up, I'm not sure. But it'll be interesting, and there'll be lots of, like we said, it'll be Cal. That's what it'll be. All right. And
for those of you watching online, I apologize earlier. I'm a little tired, a little anal retentive, and I wrote the script this week. So I'm not used to writing the script when Opus is here. And so when I'm here, I kind of try to stick to it as much as possible. So my fault. I'm tired. Bear with me. Better Tracy next week.
It's all right, Tracy. It's all good. So, tomorrow, the Marijuana Zone will be here. Check out Matt. He's always interesting. I know he's got something good scheduled for tomorrow, but I don't know what it is. But I know it looked good.
Well, you know, Matt's always pulls off a great show. And I, like I said, it's been a crazy day. We just got back last night, so I haven't done a lot much of travel on the computer, but watch it crash, dump, and die on me all day.
yeah, that sucks.
Yes.
And I've been having like video issues, but that's okay.
Oh, we got video up. They're awesome.
Well, we got
and,
some up. Yeah.
I think we should make a shout out to everybody at the Vernon Health Center. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Selena. Thank you, Ben.
Yes.
Thank you, Jody.
I'm not wearing your shirt today, but
you,
I will.
Thank you, Donna Jo. Thank you, Mark, and everybody at Cannabis Culture Pod TV headquarters. You guys rock.
Oh, one more. I want you to, one more thing. If you get a chance, go to cannabisdigest.ca and Debbie Stoltz Griffin.
And I want to say one more special thank you.
Okay.
I want to say a special thank you to Opus's family out on the West Coast, his in-laws or his daughter's family, everybody out there. It was a wonderful wedding and a beautiful wedding, beautiful family. So a shout out to everybody who's watching because I bet you Pauline will. And so shout out to them, you know.
Pauline who watches the show. I was so surprised.
Thank you very much for all the people in the West Coast who showed us love.
Yeah, that was awesome. Thanks, everybody. And thank you to LaFumo Pipes for putting up this great raffle prize that we're going to be selling tickets for. And we have Opus Live t-shirts for $20. If you're interested, see me right here after the show. I got them. And what else? Thank you, Tracy, for coming on the show. And I think you better can the monster-sized Slurpee next time. I don't know. Might be too much sugar in that thing. So what else? Till next week, cultivate your freedom. This is Opus Live. Be good.
Much more simple. I've got a working